Barefoot investor Scott Pape tried for 2 years to get financial literacy taught in schools. And when he failed to do it, he decided to help kids get money savvy himself.
And Scott's new book, Barefoot Kids, is teaching primary school children how to be smart with their dollars. And he joins us now live from Melbourne. Scott, welcome to the show, mate. You have spent years teaching adults to be smarter with their money. How many of them wish they could go back in time and guide them, or have them guided, sorry, when they were kids?
Yeah, after writing The Barefoot Investor, and you know, the number one thing people said to me after they actually read that book is, why am I only learning this now in my 30s or 40s or 50s or 60s? Why didn't I get taught this in schools? And so for me, the question was, well, you know, it's the one thing that every kid is going to be tested on every day of their lives, and yet we don't really teach it. So as you said, I tried to get it in schools. I failed miserably. So this is my backup plan, this book, Barefoot Kids, and it's a way of bouncing over the bureaucrats and putting it in the hands of kids everywhere.
Good man.
I think that sounds like a brilliant idea. So let's start with pocket money. What's the big mistake we're all making as parents with pocket money?
So the big mistake, there's probably two. The first one is you're actually relying on the parents doing it rather than the kids. So my view would be that I wrote this book directly to kids. The kids are in control. Parents have the final say, but the kids won't forget when it's payday. They will remind you. Don't worry about that. So it's putting the kids kind of in control so that they have ownership of it. So it's just not another thing that parents have to do. But the second one is we pay kids to do things they should be doing for free. We don't want to make everything a transaction. So in my home, my kids don't get paid to make their bed. They don't get paid to put their smelly socks into the laundry. They don't get paid to do the dishes, just as I don't get paid to put very average spaghetti bolognese on the kitchen table for them to eat. We're a family and we all pitch in. But the kids do get to choose their own pocket money jobs and even to start their own little business. And I've got kids in the book that can inspire them that have done just that.
Wow.
Andrew and I were talking off air, mate. We've both got kids. We've both admitted we need to do better. How do we empower kids with a good money mindset?
So for me, it's not really about money. When you're talking to kids about money, it can feel sort of capitalistic and consumeristic. For me, what it's about is just teaching them the basics of life, which is money comes from working. You'll be amazed at the 35-year-olds who I meet who haven't made that connection. So we want our kids to be hard workers. We want them to spend and spend wisely, because nobody likes a tightwad. We want kids to save up for something that they like, as in a goal achievement, delaying the gratification. And we want them to give. And that's why we've got the little jar system. We want kids to be givers, because we know that they're the most happiest people. Maybe it might be buying some flowers for Gran. Maybe it might be doing something with Food Bank for people who are less fortunate. But if we teach our kids to be hard workers, to be goal-orientated and to be kind and generous, we've kind of done our job. That's all we have to do as parents. And as a dad of four kids, that's kind of my baseline.
Yeah, there's some gorgeous stories here in the book. You know, Olivia bought socks for homeless people, Indiana and Summer feed a family in Cambodia, all those things. But also some of the kids in here have some great money-making ideas. What sort of things are they doing?
Oh, it's awesome. So I'll just say quickly, I wrote the best-selling book of all time. So I thought I was pretty good as a writer, but I had four very grumpy editors, being my children, and I would write hilarious stories and I would go home and read it to the kids at night. And I had like literally 15 seconds and my kids would be like, Dad, this is not very funny. It's kind of boring. You need to get to the point. I'm like, okay. And so what I decided was me as a dad is probably not the right person to be talking to the kids as much. So what I did is I got 50 Aussie kids aged between 5 and 14 to inspire kids. So we've got kids in there that have started their own slime businesses, dog walking businesses, and they're making like seriously thousands of dollars. We've got kids that have got little flower shops at the end of their street with an honesty box. It is just so inspiring what these kids have done. And they're making good money, but even more than that, they're learning to smile, make eye contact, ask questions. They're really proving to themselves that they're good with money. So it's one thing to be lectured if you're a kid, but to go out there and to prove it to yourself and to have that brag-worthy rights of parents, What that happens when you start to do that is kids go, yeah, I am good with money. So that when they turn 17 and 18, they look at Afterpay and just laugh. They don't take the credit cards. They're confident within themselves. And that's kind of the gift that I want to give every Aussie kid. And that's why I wrote the book.
Sensational, mate. Now, before we let you go, you tell children to start earning compound interest as soon as possible. Now, what is the best way to do that? And why is it so important?
So in the book, I talk about, I break down investing really simply for kids. You can start investing with as little as $5 these days. You just download an investment app, got it in the book, but basically kids can start investing. And I've got an 8-year-old who talks about how she and her mum actually learned to invest together. So the cool thing about that is that if you're an investor and you're still in primary school, that becomes a bit of a belief and part of who you are. Yeah. And it's so much easier than other people that don't learn about this stuff until they're 40 or 50 or 60 and they're sitting over the table from a financial advisor completely freaking out. So again, for me, what I want to do is make this these behaviours just habitual. You know, it's just part of who these kids are, and that is what's going to pay dividends.
Yeah, I hope you do get this into schools as well, because it seems like a no-brainer, but we do have the book. Scott's new book, Barefoot Kids, is out now. Scott, thanks so much for joining us.
Well done, mate.
I really appreciate it. Thank you.